Eimer. Hey, what's up, guys? Today I'm gonna show y'all how to make beats for Trippie Redd and Lil Uzi Vert. They just dropped their new song, Holy Smokes, and I'm gonna show y'all how I made the beat that you heard in the beginning and how to make beats for those two. Yeah, before we start, if you want any of my sounds, I got a one-shot kit available, some loop kits. Yeah, you can go and check those out if you want to. I would really appreciate your support. But now let's start with the beat. So right here you can see the project for the loop, for the melody. This is what it sounds like. Yeah, this is the melody, and I'm gonna show you how I made it. So we're gonna start with the first sound, the synth right here. This is just some chords. You can see, like, it's a chord progression. It goes up and goes down. Yeah, so this is the first sound right here. Yeah, I'm gonna show you how I made the chords. I'm gonna like replicate them over here. So I started with the bass notes. You can see it goes up the scale, right? And then it goes back down again. So just the root notes right here. And then afterwards you wanna like make chords out of it. So just these notes right here. Yeah. And now you have chords. But those chords are very, like, they are boring, you know? Like, there's nothing going on with those chords. Yeah, we've all heard that a million times. But now you wanna like spice things up. So you wanna invert notes or like change some notes, move some notes, whatever. So how I like got that exact progression was for the first chord, I just took out the middle note, duplicated those and pitched it up an octave. That's how I got the first chord, this one right here. For the second chord, I took out the middle note, duplicated the root note, and pitched it up an octave, so to D sharp right here. And then I also added the C up here, because why not? It sounded pretty cool because I wanted it to go up, you know. So if I left that C out, it would like, it felt like it was going down, you know what I'm saying? So I had to add a note up here, and the C sounded good, so that's why I added that note. And then for the third chord over here, I duplicated these both and pitched them up an octave. What's going on? And then I took out the middle note as well. That's how I got the chords right here. Yeah, and then over here, all I did was I copied this over and added the C on top because it's like the top note of the chord. And I added the C over here. And then the second one is just this chord copied over again. This is the second one. And then for the last one, for the last chord, all I did was I duplicated this whole chord, pitched it up an octave, removed these two. Only two, these two. So I have the root note down here, the bass note, and then I added the seventh note to the chord, and this is what the progression sounds like. Yeah, so that's how I made the chords, but obviously in the beat you can see it's not just the chords, but I also chopped them up so it has like a nice rhythm to it. You can see that over here. So I chop the chords up. And that's pretty much the chords. So the like this like the bass of the beat really. The sound that I used was this sound right here. You can see it. I'm not trying to pronounce anything because I'm scared I'll do it wrong, so you can see the sound. And then afterwards you can see there's a lot of empty space right here between the chords, and that's where I put the this lead right here. Yeah, this lead is to like transition between the chords, and it fills up this empty space between them. And then I added this main melody, like this main melody lead. Yeah, let's check the sound for this as well. If you want to know how I come up with these leads, because it's like actually really simple, I explained that already in a different video. You can like check it out. It pops up in the top right corner now, so you can go and check that out. I go very like in depth in that tutorial. Yeah, so this is the sound for the main lead. Yeah, and then the thing is that these two leads, they don't go very well with each other because like they sound muddy together, like they clash with each other. So I did not play them together, but I like split them up and played them at like separate times through the loop. But yeah, that's like the melody. And for the mixing, I didn't do anything really. I just added some reverb for the like main lead right here. So now that we have that, we can move on to the drums. This right here is the project for the drums. You can see I have my loop exported and like made a new project for it. That's how I do it. And then we're gonna start with the 808 right here. Nothing crazy on the 808. It just follows the root notes of the chords, so like it has the same rhythm as well. So it goes up and goes down, and then over here this is just to transition over to the start, and sounds pretty cool in my opinion. Then I added a clap, like, nothing crazy on the clap. And then for the snare, I don't have anything going on over here, just something like a little snare roll at the end, just to give it like energy and like a better transition. Then the hi-hats. So you can see it's not like a two-step pattern, but it has like a rhythm to it. It has like this stop and go feeling to it, you know, like it stops and then like it goes and then it stops, and it's like very chopped. It has a very chopped feeling. Yeah. And then the open head to finish it off. This just accents like the rhythm and the 808 notes. For the mixing, the 808, just an EQ right here and over here as well. The clap, simple EQ, just to take out a bit of the low end of the clap. And then reverb, but you can see it's like very low, so almost like all the way down. On the snare roll, I have the same thing. And then the hi-hats, I actually added an Effectrix, so it reverses the hi-hats at certain parts. And then the open hat, a bit of reverb and EQ to take out a bit of the low end on the open hat. And that's pretty much it for the mixing. On the master, I just have this EQ because I felt like there was a bit too much high end going on, so I took out a bit of it. Another EQ right here, just to, you know, adjust little things. And then of course the soft clipper, and that's it for the beat. Yeah, that's how you make beats for Trippie Redd and Lil Uzi Vert, how to make like a Holy Smokes type beat. Hope you enjoyed. So like, comment, subscribe, and comment what you want to see next, because I'm trying to do some more tutorials. And yeah, just let me know what you want to see. Yeah, have a great day.